Open world games have become a massive genre in recent years as technology gets greater and greater and developers keep trying to outdo each other. Competition breeds success and the consumer is usually the one to benefit, and there's some pretty sweet open world games that are coming out next year. Well, it may be 2008 by the time you watch this, I don't know. Today, I decided to throw together the ones that I am the most hyped for, so let's do it. What's up, guys? Jimmy here, welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today we're going to be taking a look at and counting down 10 open world games that are coming out in 2018 that you should probably get excited for. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Kicking off our list is one that has a lot of hype around it already, especially after E3. At number 10, Sea of Thieves. And supposedly this game is going to be a glorious return to the form for Rare. And the team behind such classics as Donkey Kong Country, Conker's Bad Fur Day, Banjo-Kazooie, and Battletoads, it's time for them to come back into the forefront. While the studio's kind of had a bit of a drop in quality ever since being bought by Microsoft, they reportedly had a much more creative control over Sea of Thieves, and it's shaping up to be one of their finest works in years. Sea of Thieves is an open-world multiplayer pirate game where you get to travel the seas, discover new islands and treasures, and even engage other players and crews in battle in order to secure the best booty. The game will also feature Rare's signature cartoonish style and humor, which is something we haven't seen from them in a while, and it is set for release of March 20th of 2018 on the Xbox One and the PC. At number 9, we have Monster Hunter World. This newest entry in the Monster Hunter series, it's going to feature some really cool things that fan loves about the previous Monster Hunter games, although much bigger. According to Capcom, development started in 2014, and there was a full year of just straight brainstorming, trying to make it the deepest, most engaging game that they possibly could. And by judging the early footage, that's going to pay off. Monster Hunter World is currently set for January 2018 release, which is right around the corner for all three platforms, PC, Xbox One, and PS4. Although there's no set release date for PC yet, but it definitely is coming. Hopefully they won't have to wait too long on that platform. At number 8, we have Kingdom Come Deliverance. This upcoming action RPG is being developed by Warhorse Studios and published by Deep Silver. Set in the medieval times, I love medieval games. Kingdom Come Deliverance is being referred to many as the most realistic version of Skyrim ever made, as the developers went to great lengths to make it as realistic and historically accurate as possible. I'm personally pretty stoked for this game. You play as a young man trying to get revenge against those who killed his family, as well as you want to restore your rightful ownership of the throne. You will learn new combat techniques throughout the game, all of which are historically accurate and were actually used during that time period. The music, the armor, the architecture are all supposed to be as accurate as possible, and the game is currently shaping up to be one of the most accurate portrayals of medieval times that we've ever seen in a video game. So if they actually deliver, it's probably going to be pretty amazing. At number 7, we have We Happy Few. This is an indie survival game that has a very interesting visual style and concept, which a lot of indie titles do. The game is set in the 60s, where everyone is drugged up all the time as the world is on the verge of falling apart after World War II, although this is a different timeline where the results are a little different. In order to try and forget about all the troubles in the world, everyone starts taking a strange drug called Joy, and it causes them to be happy all the time. Your character becomes a target of all the drugged up residents of the city as he refuses to take Joy, which results in a horrific, trippy survival horror experience. It looks pretty cool. The game entered early access in July of 2016 and is set for a full release on PC and consoles in April of the coming year. At number 6, we have Spider-Man, and this upcoming Spidey game has a simple title, as if to say that the character is back and doesn't need any introduction. This open-world superhero game will feature the player taking control of Spidey himself in an open-world New York City that has been carefully recreated. You can swing around the world, crawl on pretty much any wall you want. Apparently, there's also going to be a pretty awesome parkour system for the areas where you don't exactly have enough room to swing, but you still want to get around quickly. The story is going to follow Spider-Man's conflict with Wilson Fisk and is not going to follow any existing comic or movie storyline, meaning that this is a brand new story in every way possible. We don't have an exact release date on the game yet, but we all know that it will be released before the end of quarter 2 in 2018, barring any setbacks. Cracking into the top 5 today, we have Metal Gear Survive. This is a pretty interesting idea for a game that has some mixed receptions from fans, and Metal Gear Survive is going to be an open-world online-only survival game set in the Metal Gear universe with a story that falls in between MGS5 Ground Zeroes and MGS5 The Phantom Pain. Konami has stated that it will be a fresh take on the series' famed stealth elements, as well as a feature a unique co-op setting that is designed for a truly engrossing multiplayer experience. Those are some pretty big words. Fans are a little skeptical of an online survival game in the Metal Gear universe, with some fearing that this will just be a quick cash grab of a game. Although, Hideo Kojima himself has stated that he wanted to do a zombie game in this universe ever since 2013. So, I don't know. He doesn't have anything to do with the development of Metal Gear Survive, so let's hope Konami's replacement for the legend is up to the task. Probably one of the most hyped first-person shooters of the year, definitely Far Cry number 5, right? I mean, let me know in the comment section. It was delayed once again recently, but we're still supposed to get it in 2018, and you will be playing as members of a small town in Montana, United States, as a violent religious cult has grown and taken over the town. It's up to you guys to rally your troops together and bring down the cult, restoring peace to your county. Sounds pretty intense. Far Cry 5 has already stirred up a great deal of controversy due to its religious themes, and I'm sure that these controversies will get bigger and bigger as the release date gets closer and closer. Originally, Far Cry 5 was rumored to come out late this year, although it was later pushed back to February, and recently, Ubisoft announced that the date was pushed back once again all the way to March, but that's still not too far out, and as long as we get it next year, I'm okay with that. At number 3, we have one of the most anticipated reboots in a long, long time, God of War. Legendary hack and slash series, most of you probably know, but it has some huge shoes to fill when it comes to the other games. The previous games in the series have featured somewhat of a linear level design, and it was more about the combat and the boss fights. But this one, the 2018 reboot, will feature extremely different gameplay, focusing more on the RPG elements like crafting and replacing Kratos' signature double-chain blades with a battle axe. People are skeptical of the new God of War game, as things don't normally go too well when a series makes a dramatic shift. But after seeing the early gameplay and the promo material, I'm hyped for it, and a lot of other people are as well. I'm hyped for the storyline of it myself. I think Sony knows what they're doing with this one. I think people are going to be pleasantly surprised. At number 2, we have Fortnite. I know what you guys are thinking. Fortnite's already here, Jimmy. Well, no, it's technically not. It has been in paid early access since July of 2017, with the Battle Royale standalone mode being released in September. However, the full game is yet to actually be released, and right now, it is set for a 2018 release. While it has not been officially confirmed what day Fortnite will launch, Epic Games has stated it will be coming next year. Now, if you watched my facts video on Fortnite the other night, which hopefully you guys have, if not, it's a late night squad video, it goes up later at night, you'll know that this game has been delayed time and time again, with it currently having been in development for 7 years. So don't be surprised if we see another delay. But personally, I think Epic is going to stick with this release this time. I really do. People are absolutely loving the early access version of the game. So if I were them, I would want to capitalize on all the hype surrounding the game right now and get the full product out to the world, into gamers' hands, as soon as they can. And finally, there's no surprise to this. There's not. Number 1. Red Dead Redemption 2. I'm sure you guys saw it coming. It's the long-awaited sequel to one of the greatest games of all time and Rockstar's first game in 5 years. Despite it having 2 in the name, this Wild West-themed game is actually going to be a prequel to the first game, following the story of an outlaw named Arthur Morgan, and it's not clear how it's going to tie into the original game yet, but Red Dead Redemption has a lot to live up to when it comes before. I mean, it's a sequel to what is unanimously considered one of the best games ever made, but if I know anything about Rockstar, they're up to the challenge. You guys know they are. They don't leave any detail out, and I have no doubt that the game is going to blow all of us away. After a few delays, RDR2 is currently slated for a release in the second quarter of 2018. Whether that happens or not, I don't know. This is a massive undertaking, and Rockstar takes their sweet time to make sure they get everything right. But once we do get it, it's going to be amazing. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 open world games that you should be pretty hyped for in 2018. Let me know if we missed any, some others that should be on this list. Make sure you guys turn on your notifications, ring the little bell, check the box so you never miss an upload. And there is a link below if you want to submit ideas for future top 10s. Who knows? It could end up being on the channel. I hope you guys have a fantastic night. If you're still up in a few hours, a late night facts video will go up. Let me know if you guys check that out. I'll see you tomorrow.